在美国波士顿的侨界又是怎么庆祝105年双十国庆呢？这一次是在9月份侨委会的国庆文化访问团精彩表演之后揭开序幕，一直到日前的双十游行都吸引大批美国友人、侨胞乡亲参与。而游行当天呢，前波士顿市长雷夫莲也受邀前来，为牌匾语句“天下为公，礼义廉耻”的中英文说明牌举行揭牌仪式。
波士顿庆祝双十国庆游行，今年有将近1000人参加。出发前，驻波士顿办事处长赖明奇邀请当年为华埠楼牌树立说明碑的前波士顿市长雷夫莲，以及现任波士顿市议会议长吴敏和波士顿侨领陈玉礼等人，为镶嵌在华埠楼牌柱子上的“天下为公，礼义廉耻”中英文并列说明牌揭碑。游行当天风和日丽，大家高举青天白日满地红国旗，将整个华埠的街道挤得水泄不通。参加人士从坐娃娃车的小朋友到高龄80-90岁的耆老都有，还有中华民俗艺术工作坊的美少女舞团以及强悍的美国民兵现场鸣枪，现场热闹极了。其中高龄80多岁、每年都协助举办国庆活动的陈玉礼也专程前来参加游行。
I have been back to the United States for 68 years. I have been celebrating the birthday of the Republic of China for 68 years. I hope I will continue to celebrate, and I hope next year we will make it bigger, more glorious.
Today's ceremony is not just a celebration of the National Day of ROC Taiwan. It also represents the friendship between Taiwan and the overseas Chinese community. And it means so much for people from Taiwan to see such a good support.
几位主流政要贵宾也纷纷致辞，肯定华裔社区对于美国以及波士顿的贡献。
We want the people of Boston want to thank all of you from the Asian American community, Chinese American community, for all that you have done in building Boston. You heard Frankie, and you know, I've been friendly with these fellows for 60, 70 years, and they're special people. They really are. And I'm talking to the Consul General, and I'm talking about the great contributions.That you have, you and your family have made to our city. And so thank you for that. A special thank you, by the way, to our veterans.
非常荣幸的能够代表所有来自台湾的遗产。我的父母1983年从台北移民到美国来，然后我每天都非常非常感谢他们，他们到这个国家来，就是对于自由，对于民主，对于共同利益 的这个重视，所以非常荣幸能够跟大家在一起庆祝双十节。
整场活动有郑义俊率领大家一起唱中华民国国歌，以及剑桥合唱团演唱的中华民国颂，并在全场一同齐唱梅花中结束。台湾电视周菊子，美国波士顿采访报道。